اذكركم خلال هالجلسه اي سؤال عن الاس ام اس، فورد لنا بعض الاسئله، ولكن اسمحوا لنا انه نقسم هالاسئله لمجموعات، كل مجموعه بتتلائم مع السيشن اللي هي رح تجي خلال النهار والجلسات رح تكون خلال النهار. من هالاسئله اللي ممكن نحن نقدر خلال هذه الجلسه ان نستفيد منها، السؤال الاول مع المحامي الاستاذ جابي، عم يسألك احدهم انه هل قانون البر يشمل مواضيع التأمين؟
تمام. القانون اللي انعمل في المياه البحريه اللي نص على انه في ماده مخصصه في التأمين، وبعدين اجت المراسيم التطبيقية وفصلت موضوع التأمين. طبعا هذا القانون في احكام، انا ما بقدر احكي عن كل الاشياء، ولكن في احكام خاصه بالتأمين، لانه على صاحب الحق او على المشغل انه ان يقوم ان يشتري عقود الضمان الضروريه لحتى يكون عم يقوم بعمليه الاستكشاف او التطوير او الانتاج.
ايضا هناك سؤال للاستاذ وسام، تعتقد ممكن الحفر في الابار المحفوره حاليا لفهم الجيولوجيا بشكل افضل؟
الشغل الوحيد المعقول اللي يعطوها كأدفانتج الأبار المحفورة هي كيف أقل، ممكن كيف أقل، لكن لأنه صار له فترة طويلة ما معروف الحالة اللي ممكن ما نقدر ندخل أعمال حتى لو مثلا نعمل تجميعية معلومات مجرور محفور، ممكن ننزل أدوات فيها الأبار نقرا المعلومات اللي هي مسحوره، لو نحن هالابار محفوره هذا الشيء ممكن، لكن هالابار صار لها فتره طويله لم ننظف ولا عملنا حالة بتكون صعبه. فينا كاول نستفيد من الكلفه تصبر حفر الابار نجرب نستحسن معلومات زياده، واذا ما نجحنا فينا يمكن افضل وقت ابار جديد.
ايضا هناك سؤال بتصور يمكن الاستاذ جابي يجاوبنا عليه، هذا في حديث السفير النرويجي عندما قال ان اموال الصندوق السيادي يجب ان لا تستثمر محليا ابدا، شو تعليقك؟
لا، اول شيء انا مش اقتصادي اجاوب على هذا السؤال، رح جاوب على ما بعرف.
عم نحكي نحن عن الصندوق السيادي،
في فرق بين فكره الصندوق السيادي في فرق بين القانون الخاص الذي سوف يتم تشريعه بإدارة هذا الصندوق السيادي، وأيضا في فرق في كيفية استثمار الأموال أو رأس المال، لأنه المبدأ القانوني اللي منصوص عليه في المادة يجب أن كل العائدات البترولية يعني اللي بتساوى بترول الربح يعني تتأصل الدولة معا، يعني قصة الدولة من البترول على الصندوق السيادي الذي يجب ان يحافظ على راس ماله للاشياء المقبله، وان تستعمل العائدات من استثماره في البنى التحتيه اللبنانيه والى موردات البشريه. استثماره يعني وين بيصير استثماره شيء، ووين بنخصص العائدات الجايه من استثماره لحتى نفيد فيها البلد شيء ثاني. انا ماني خبير بالاستثمار، هذا السؤال
يمكن الاطار القانوني هو اللي بيوجب كيفيه استثمار هذه الاموال، معروف انها ممكن المفروض تستثمر بمشاريع تنمويه بالدرجه الاولى، ومن ثم قد تستثمر،
ولكن هذا القانون بده يوضح شغله، انه المبدا تم ذكره والنص عليه في الماده اللي هي بقانون 132 قانون الموارد البتروليه في المياه البحريه. هلا المشروع اللي عرضنا عليكم كمان بنص على انه ذات المبدا. المبدأ هو المحافظ على رأس هذا المال ما بنصرفه، رأس المال ما بنصرفه بنخليه بالصندوق يحفظ للأشياء المقبلة، لأنه الأصول اللي هي جاية من الموارد البترولية، الموارد الطبيعية في البحر هي أصول غير متجددة، تحويل هذه الأصول إلى أموال بلازم إنه دعم في صندوق سيادي ما نخليه نصرفه ونستخدمه. فاذا الاستثمار وين بنستثمر على القانون يلي بده يطلع هلا بده يحدد نستثمر الصندوق يقول لنا نستثمر اما الان
يحدد اوجه الاستثمار. شكرا استاذ غابي نعبول، شكرا للسادة معنا اللي شاركوا بها الجلسة، استاذ بسام شباط، استاذ بيتر براونينغ وستامبوا، استاذ جيمس هوليس، وشكر كبير لكم. ونحن وياكم ايضا راح نتابع انهار البترولي مع الجلسة الثانية تحت عنوان الموارد البترولية في المياه البحرية وقائع وآفاق، مع الساده الاستاذ وسام الذهبي رئيس وحده الشؤون الماليه والاقتصاديه في هيئه اداره قطاع البترول، والاستاذ وليد نصر رئيس وحده التخطيط الاستراتيجي في هيئه اداره قطاع البترول، والدكتور ناصر حطايط رئيس الهيئه، مع زميلنا اللي راح يدير الجلسه الثاني استاذ باسل الخطيب. نتمنى من السادة المتحدثين وزميل الخطيب يتفضلوا، رغم انه في اسئلة كثيرة بس مثل ما قلنا راح تتقسم لجلسات وفيما بعد راح تجاوب عليكم ادارة الهيئة. شكرا.
So, in the concession system, you need to have the state first the companies are concessionaires to the state. They own the resources and they pay taxes, mainly on royalty. And the contractual agreement, the property of the ownership of the resources is for the state, and mainly the state, the companies will pay profit petroleum. Usually in a country, very developed countries, I'll name UK or Norway, there are no negotiable items. There are laws and regulations and decisions, and usually companies will rely only on the existing legislation. There's no negotiation between the state and the companies. On the other side, the production sharing contracts, let's say in many countries in the whole world, you have like the contract around 150, 200, 250 pages, where each and every clause is being an article negotiated between the companies and the state. And you know the difference between the state or regulators within the state and the oil companies. There's a huge difference when it comes to negotiations and knowledge. In Lebanon, what we did, and this is the benefit, I'm trying to say this and I'll be frank, we have been criticized for the last 6 months about this hybrid system. Some, they will say, why you go for royalty, the concession, and some will say, go for contractual. I just want to say that regardless of the system, we can have the same result. Regardless of the system you choose, the same thing could be the same. You can reach the same calculation regardless of the system. In the Lebanese model, we have few negotiable items. And just to say, in the Lebanese model, that the companies have to put their state participation, and there is also, the participation of the state, which is for the first bid round, there's no state participation. And also, what's most importantly in the profit petroleum, contractual agreement is the profit sharing. Just to add, this is really a summary that in a concession system, the royalty taxes are the main government take in a concession, it's a profit petroleum. In Lebanon, we do have the three components: royalty, profit petroleum, and taxes. What are our advantages? We talk about the political situation, the security situation, what's happening, but really there are many issues that are really drive us optimistic about the whole process. Now, the Brent has decreased $20, but usually, relatively, the high oil prices have attracted the investment all over the world. And there are some declining resources. The resources all over the world, we are frontier areas, so companies are interested to come to new frontier areas to start exploration. We do have considerable moderate sizes of the blocks. We do have some 2D and 3D that are excellent in terms of quality that were conducted by two companies, Spectrum and PGS. We do have similar discoveries. We have discoveries in similar basins around us. And definitely we do have a modern, contractual framework that is recent with the assistance of the Norwegian authorities. We do have what we call in the modern contract some kind of fiscal stability. And the investor, when he will come to invest in a country, mainly he wants to see laws. He wants to see stability. He wants to see that his investment, he will get a decent return on his investment. Security issues come at the second stage. And definitely geology, you need to have good prospects. And what's really an added value to Lebanon is the proximity. We are well placed, we're not an island, we're not a country in an environment that is being isolated. Lebanon has many options, advantages, and probably my colleague Walid will elaborate more on this. So all of these attract investment, foreign investment. This is probably something, we are still, this is a cash flow, foreign oil profile, it has a bell shape, and I'm really sad to see that Lebanon, we're still in the pre-licensing stage. So the investor, this is the cash flow, the investor will start by putting some money on the pre-licensing, seismic surveys, namely, then the exploration has to drill somewhere, it has to pay more. The development, it's, you know, has to spend a couple of million, or even you will reach 100 million. Then day one, we'll start production, we'll have a bell shape at a certain time. We'll have enhanced oil recovery. Then at a certain time, we need to have investment in order to enhance the oil or gas recovery. Then we have the decommissioning. Look at this blue line, this is the investment of the state. So for the time being, Lebanon didn't put any money in a way. We didn't do any seismic survey from our expenses, the companies did. We will not do the production sharing contract, any contribution to any investment. The companies will take the risk. If they strike, if they find oil, they will come up with their cost recovery. I talked about it then, we have profit share. So this is the same thing. Just quickly to add on what we said. This is the total petroleum produced. You have royalty. We have what we refer to as disposable petroleum, which is the cost petroleum. The investor, let's say, he has to, during the first 6 years, he has invested around $1 billion, let's say. He has the right to recover his investment for the years to come from the production. Once he reduced his cost petroleum is recovered, we'll have profit petroleum. But this can happen from day one of production because we have ceiling to cost petroleum. This is the profit petroleum split between the state and the contractor. We call it contractor when it comes to contractual arrangement. Who has to pay taxes. Overall, this is the cost that is to the project, this is the company profit, and this is the government take. This is not to scale. I want to really deliver a message here that this is the total government take. It's a cake. No matter how you slice it, this is what's really important. We should not see a component in isolation of other components. We should not talk about royalty. Okay, royalty is 4%, we should put it 7 or 8 without seeing profit petroleum. What's important for us, for the Lebanese state, is to maximize, and I would like to use the word optimize, the government take. This is what's important. The more we enlarge the pie, the more pie we have for us and for the operator. So, and the Lebanese system didn't have any bonus, which makes the system progressive. We don't have any signature bonus, any production bonus. The royalties are relatively acceptable because we want to make the system progressive and not regressive. And in the case studies that will follow, I will show some simulation we did and some sensitivity analysis. We have cost petroleum. And we have the profit petroleum. I will talk about the R factor. It's something really, I consider it as a beauty, state of the art, because the R factor, it captures the cost, the production, and the prices. Let's say if the price of oil or gas increases, the state will have the maximum share. So it's not you take evenly with the companies. If the cost decreases, the R factor also increases, and the state will take, it will capture more of economic rent. There are some other issues, the state participation, the establishment of a national oil company, if you have any questions, we can discuss it. Why we didn't establish for the time being a national oil company? And what is the state participation if we want to go for some state participation? And there's an obligation to have a decommissioning fund. The R factor, it's rate of return. When R equals 1, this is important for you to know, it's break-even point. So, this is the capital inflows cumulative. So, it's cost petroleum plus profit petroleum minus operating expenses over all capital expenditures from day one. So, let's say R is less than 1. The state take is 8. So, the state, let's say, we take 40%. Once R equals 1, it starts to increase. At a certain time, when R reaches RB, let's say RB 2.5, 3, these are bidable items, the state take will be B, which is 60, 70, 80, whatever. The total government take is the state take over. lifetime of the project, and this is very important to understand. This is an auction, this is a bid, museum. You have royalty, you have taxes, and this is the Buffett Petroleum. Case study one. This is a, probably you know that if you look at the map, you'll be able to know which block this is. This structure. Let's say two case studies just to make you more familiar with the system we have. Let's say you have a total production of 25 years. The size, this is a moderately, not a big structure, 2.9 TCF, trillion cubic feet, and to the power 12 cubic feet. The capital expenditures are 1.3 billion. There are 12 drilled, and the operating expenses are less. There are around 1 billion. This is operating expenses on a yearly basis. What are the assumptions? Economic input. This is what we will use. This is a low price. We're saying, okay, we'll sell the gas at $6 per MMBTU. We have royalty. This is fixed, 4%. The corporate income tax is 15%. The withholding tax is 10%. So overall, the operator for the time being has to pay 23.5%. Inflation, we consider it as 4%. We use a discount rate of 10%. There's no state participation. There are training obligations for during exploration and during production, and there are some area fees. These are small amounts. So, what are the little items? Let's say a company X will come, they will say, we will give you 60% ceiling, we'll have RB3.5 and A and B. These are only the input from the companies. We take all of these, we put them in our model, and we see what will happen. What is the state take? We calculate over 25 years, the state came to be 350 million, the royalty, profit petroleum 7.8 billion, and taxes 1.5 billion. We have a state take of 76%. The contractor take is 100 minus 76, and the rate of return is 70.2. What do I mean by this? I mean, even as a conclusion for this slide, for a small prospect, relatively, the state take is 76, and the rate of return is acceptable for the operator at 17%. So our aim in the Petroleum Administration, our aim for the state is that the operator will develop even small structure or medium structure. Some big companies are interested to developing structures for TCF and above. But we need to make a fiscal model, and this is important, that is appealing to everybody. We need to have exploitation. We need to have production for small structure. This is a small field for 25 years, $10 billion. A small structure, not field even. So within this block also, we have other structures. And this is block one, by the way. So, this is, if we take block one also, and we try to do some sensitivity analysis. For the sake, this is another structure, 4.4 TCF. We do have different capex, different opex. We increase the price of the gas. With the inflation, state participation are the same. What would be, you know, the conclusion for this? For 4%, we increase the royalty from 4 to 12. There was an article in Daily Star, Mahan, Dorian Lejour, by one of the biggest people we respect. He said, Lebanon is losing $14 billion. He said, how can we do this? This is illogical. How can we do it? He said, increase the royalty from 4 to 12. The Israelis have a royalty of 12.5. But the Israelis, they don't have profit sharing. They have what they call as concession. They started by having a system that is not good, then they linked the taxes to the R factor. We did from day one better than their system. So, if we do some sensitivity analysis, for 4% to 12%, okay, the royalty will increase in terms of revenues, the profit petroleum will decrease, and overall, what we will do is that we will lose in terms of total government take. C'est un vase communicant. If you increase one thing, something else will decrease. It's not, we hear sometimes, okay, increase the royalty to 10, increase the taxes to 50, increase. You cannot increase everything. There is a certain rate of return that any oil company will have to secure in order to give development. Or they will come and they will say it's not economically feasible to do it. That's why our aim is to have a progressive system. And I have to move to the conclusion. So this is, the overall loss is 5.5 billion due to, you know, increase in royalty. So what's the conclusion? These are two slides. And sorry, I'm talking technically. Royalty usually it's not something that is, you see it in profit petroleum. Profit petroleum, Tafasul Hemdesh, it's only profit petroleum. We include it as a component. Why did we include royalty? We include royalty just to secure early cash for the state, this is one, and to make some auditing on the gross production. If we have some power plants, we will have, we have power plants that run on natural gas, we can take the royalty in kind and operate the power plants. So if you have big royalties, small fields will not be developed. So this is regressive. Okay, if we increase it, the companies will come and they will do their economics and they will not develop small fields. That's why royalty should be seen as a progressive instrument, not that big, because some small fields will never be developed. And it should be seen as part of the total government aid. Some countries, they started with the royalty, I'll give an example of Norway, with time, in order to promote investment, encourage investment of marginal fields, they removed the royalty, and companies like to pay taxes on their income, because once they have income, they like to pay taxes. This is progressive, but they don't like to pay it from day one. And in all cases, it's not that we have royalty of 4%, I'm talking about gas. We do have a 4%, but at the same time, we do have cost profit petroleum. So from year one, this is my last slide, sorry, I have to go back and make some emphasis on this. Oops. Okay. Sorry, I have to go back to this slide of profit sharing. Bear with me on here. Petroleum, cost profit petroleum. And companies will come and they will say, as I gave in my example, we'll pay 60%. So 60% will recover the cost. The remaining, this will go to the state. And from day one, I have more than 4% royalty. There is a royalty, but I'm calling it as profit petroleum. I'm not allowing companies to recover their cost from day one. Let's say they produced 100 barrels. They'll have to pay for. They will say, they will claim, okay, we invested, so we need the whole rest of 96. We'll tell them, no, there's a ceiling to what you can recover. Then you recover for other years to come till full recovery. But the remaining part is we go directly to the state. There will be some profit sharing mechanism. This is the message I want to deliver about having profit petroleum. And I will have to end up by the last slide. Sorry. Okay. After the conclusion on royalty, just to give, you know, some, we did some studies about some countries. We have to differentiate between royalty on concession countries like Abu Dhabi, UAE, Albania, Algeria, Angola, and some PSCs countries. Concession on average for royalty for 30 countries on gas is 8.5 for concession, where royalty is really a component, and for the PSC, it is 3.62. Conclusion. The total government take, this is not the percentage that we throw at, or we say we can reach. We don't know. Really, it depends on the companies that will bid, which blocks they will bid on, And what's important is that we should manage our expectation. The first licensing round, we might not get very excellent offer as our second licensing round if there are some discoveries. What's important is that we proceed. This is not something, you know, we're very proud of the system, but this is something that is a dynamic. We're not fixing everything. There is a bit component. We should start. And this is, as the ambassador of Norway said, this is learning by doing, but this is based on the best practices all over the world. This is the total government take, the last slide. You know, you see here, look at, you know, Iran, for instance. The state take is more than 1992. Venezuela also. You know, because they have some service fees. The operator will come and they will pay him. Saudi Arabia, it's not mentioned here. As we go, some countries like Ireland, they have 40. It can go from 40 to 30. You see the two arrows? So it's not fixed. Usually, it ranges the total government thing, but overall, this is for oil. Overall, this is how it looks like. We should compare Lebanon to similar countries with the same environment, same structure, deep offshore, and we should, at the end, manage our expectation. Thank you very much.